You're casually swiping on your favorite social media feed, and suddenly you see an advertisement about a product you were just talking about a couple of hours ago. It's exactly what you've been looking for, and even has a promotional price tag on it. Such a deal. Do you really think this is cool? Well, have you ever wondered what data is being collected for you to see this ad? Through which agreement and under which conditions? Let me talk to you about a couple of concepts. Historically, the legal and economic framework of property rights came from land ownership. Then it was extended to copyrights, and it has spread to data. Just as an example, the priciest technology companies around the world have about 80% of its assets under the category of intangible assets, and that's by no means a coincidence. For a big part of this percentage is software code, and even more importantly, the data they own. Data is the most valuable resource on the planet. People create it, and yet, corporations own it. Now let's go back to our example. Do you remember those questions? You only saw the right ad because of corporations' vast data ownership. And for you seeing ads like this, corporations even get paid by advertisers. After all, data monopolies get richer and richer by using your data and time. We believe it's time for a rethink. For us, generating data as we go through our daily lives is a kind of work. It is labor. We really should be paid for this work. And this is where the core of data dignity resides. Let us all unite and build institutions that allow us all together to bargain for a fair data wage and properly structure the data economy.